What's up, guys? Iván Carranza here, and welcome to Bass Tone Tuesday. Today, we're gonna talk about compressors for bass, and more specifically, the 1176 style of compressors. I think, you know, at some point, you might want to get a compressor, and you look on the internet, like, what's the best compressor for bass, or on TalkBass, the forum, you know, what are some of the best compressors for bass, on pedals and whatnot. And the truth is that there are different compressors that bring a different flavor to the table and, you know, work better in different scenarios. Now, I really like the 1176 style of compressors due to its aggressive and greedy character and its ability to bring the bass a bit more forward in the mix. There are other compressors that are also great, and I might do videos about them, but I want to talk about the 1176 today. Now, before we continue, let me tell you that there are indeed pedals specifically made for bass that are created, you know, based around the circuitry of the 1176 rack unit. For example, the Kali Compact Bass or the Kali 76. The Darkglass Hyperluminal also has an 1176 function, and there's the MXR bass compressor as well. So you do have options to use your pedal board when playing live and gigging or when recording at home if you don't want to invest in a rack unit or if you don't want to buy plugins. What's interesting about the 1176 are the attack and release times, because they are extremely fast. They can get like super lightning quick. And you know, by playing around with those two controls, you can get some pretty interesting results. Additionally, the way to start triggering compression here is different than some other compressors, because on some other studio or rack units, and also some pedals, you have a threshold and you can, you know, lower the threshold or raise the threshold to start triggering compression. Here, however, the only way to start triggering compression is to raise the input signal. So you increase the volume, but at the same time, you start compressing the signal, which is pretty interesting. And the input control works somewhat in conjunction with the output control, because the more signal you boost and the more compression you're triggering, you also have to adjust the output volume. And that, together with the attack and release times, creates some very cool sounds. On top of that, there's the cool all buttons in mode, which means that you press all the ratio buttons, which go like 4 to 1, 8 to 1, 12 to 1, and 20 to 1. And by pressing all of them at the same time, that sends the compressor into like a rage and starts compressing widely. And it makes whatever you're feeding into the compressor like really like up front and in your face, and also distorts the signal a bit. And that creates some richness in the harmonics, which makes the signal also stand out a bit more. For the video and to hear how the compressor works, we're gonna take a look at two samples. One is a rock track, and the other one is a fingerstyle groove with also some slapping and popping happening there. And we're gonna take a look at the controls and, you know, what the 1176 does to the signal for the bass on its own and also in the mix. So let's take a look at my screen. Here we already have the 1176 open. And this one is a plugin of the Ref A, which is the classic one. It's a replication of the very first 1176. And we also have this one, which is the low noise version. And it's a bit more transparent, not as greedy as the other one. But if we take a look at the controls, we have from left to right, the input, which, like I mentioned earlier, also controls how much compression is going to be applied. The more you boost it, the more compression is going to happen. Then we have the output, and that controls the volume going out of the compressor. Then we have the attack and release knobs. And the attack goes from slowest, turned counterclockwise, to the fastest, going clockwise. So the knob to the left is a slow attack, which means that the compressor takes longer to grab the note and start compressing it. And a fast attack means the compressor reacts very, very quickly and compresses the note. And the release knob works the same way. To left is a very slow release, so the note gets compressed longer because it releases the note slower. And to the right is a very fast release, which means that the note is released, it's compressed and then released almost immediately, which, you know, causes a different effect. Then we have the ratio switches. And the cool thing, like I also said, you can put all the buttons in and that creates a smashing, brutal sound. We're also going to take a look at. And I'm going to play you the track, then solo the bass and show you the compressor. We're going to listen in the mix and, you know, play around with the controls a little bit. So this is the track. Bass on its own. Right, and the compressor is off right now. So if I just turn it on, I'm gonna loop these four bars here, and I'm gonna turn it on and off. It's off. I haven't touched the settings. And right off the bat, that already puts the bass much more forward in the mix. I'm gonna check the output volumes or the output level. So it's a 1 dB louder, so I'm gonna pull back a bit on the output. That's about the same volume. Now off. On again. Now you can hear immediately it puts the bass a lot more forward in the mix. It gives it a bit more presence. And I have the attack and release knobs all the way up. Now let's play around with the control. So I want to leave the release there, but I'm going to move around the attack. Right now, I'm compressing about 3 dB. Still, you still hear the bass a lot more. It has more presence in the mix. Now, I'm gonna boost some more compression to bring more signal into the circuitry. And for that, I'm gonna pull back on the output. Now, I'm gonna loop another section. And let's listen to it first without the compressor. Right, it pushes the bass a lot more forward. So one cool trick about this compressor, especially in the Rev A, is its ability to bring out this harmonic distortion, especially on the old buttons in mode. Let's listen to that. Now off. On. But you get that really like in your face presence, and on some overdrive as well. Now in the mix. And it's even more pronounced if you bump the attack at the fastest setting. Right, so you can do that, for example. So this is another track, and you've probably heard this one if you've been to my channel. Let me play it for you without the compressor first. And if we zoom in on the track, you can see this very big transients here. Those are the pops of the slap, and that creates like a very loud spike. And a compressor is great to tame those frequencies. So this is what I dialed in for the track, for example. Let me play it again from the beginning. So just keeps the volume between fingers and slap a bit more even. Like that. This is without a compressor, right? It's with. And if I turn the attack knob to the fastest setting, it compresses a lot more. But I want to get some articulation there, like this. So I'm not like massively compressing anything, right? Now, if I was to do that trick that we did last time, I can pull back a little on the volume and boost some more here. So I can pull back a little more. Listen to that mix. Right, the compressor does push the bass a bit more forward. It gives it more, articulation, without being too aggressive, though. Now, if I was to, like, really go all buttons in, without. That's a bit too much. It's a bit too aggressive, too distorted as well. Right, but you don't necessarily have to do that. But as you can see, using an 1176 is a great way to bring some more presence to a bass track. And you can set it in many different ways. You can also like use the different ratios to tame if you are like have very loud spikes. You can use it as a limiter, but it's a great tool to bring the bass a bit more forward and give it presence in the mix.
I hope you guys liked the video. Let me know in the comments what is your favorite compressor so far. Also, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay up to date with the content that's coming to the channel. As always, thank you guys for watching. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Take care.